Our group of 9 climbers and 2 guides assembled in Geneva. From the left are Brett Falk, John Clear, our leader, Dr. Roger Mosley, Steve Falk, and my old friend Bert Falk. On the far right is Anne Crary. We drove through the beautiful Swiss countryside to the town of Urwola. Arriving in Urwola, we stayed in a hotel. The Urwola Valley is surrounded by beautiful peaks. We set up our camp just outside of town. We're going to practice with our ice axes and crampons on the glaciers on Mont Cologne, just outside of town. With this preparation, we're off to our first climb, the Petit Pont de Vesivy. Some of our group weren't experienced in rock climbing, and as a result, it took us a long time to get to the summit, and even longer to get down. On the down climb, we had 2 rope pitches and 5 rappels. At the base of the climb, we set off a small avalanche, which set up like concrete around our feet. Bedtime was 2 a.m. Bad weather led to a day of practice in a local ski lift facility. We spent the next 2 nights at the Vignette Spot. Next is a climb of Pin de Rolla, followed by a climb of L'Evêque the next day.
Our climb of L'Evêque would have been pretty uneventful if my pack hadn't been knocked off the summit, and it wouldn't have been so bad if it didn't have a jar of strawberry jam in it. And when I got down to it here on the moraine, somebody was going through it and taking stuff out of it. We left Urwola backpacking to Zermatt over the top of the Tête Blanche. I remember the ladders to the Bertholdt hut being icy and pretty slippery. As we neared Zermatt, we got a glimpse of the Matterhorn.
Our co-leader, Bill O'Connor, is in the left foreground. If you're going to toot your horn in Switzerland, you better bring along somebody to help you carry it. Marmots! The Matterhorn was too icy for us to climb it this trip. Our next climb was the high point of Switzerland, the Duferspitz on Monte Rosa. We crossed the Gornergrat Glacier and spent the night at the Monte Rosa hut. We had to work our way around a Korean team that were stuck on a knife edge ridge on the way to the summit. A snapshot
in the family out. We returned later in the day to the Monte Rosa hut. The next day, we hiked out and returned to Zermatt. The little cemetery in Zermatt has memorials to the guides that have lost their lives guiding in these mountains. We're off in the van to Chamonix in France for our final climb of Mont Blanc.
When we got to Chamonix, we stayed at the Chamonillard Hotel. All in all, it was all just breaks in the wall.
teleférique station at the top of the Aiguille du Midi. Our ride up the teleférique. The climb and summit of Mont Blanc. A statue of De Saussure, the first to climb Mont Blanc.
We spent the next few days around Chamonix. This is our camp outside of town. We said our goodbyes and departed by train for Geneva. The Jet d'Eau Fountain.
Our boat tour of Lake Geneva. Final glimpse of the Matterhorn.